saying.
Yeah.
What about to do now?
What about to do now?
It's all dramatic on this shit.
Yeah.
You're all right, nigga.
Calm down.
Ladies and gentlemen, as I look left, as I look right, as I look down the middle, pause. You know what I'm saying? This is the slide through. We're here with my man Chris Clay to the left of me, to the right of me. I got my man Paco.
Yeah.
With the enforcer in two. In front of me.
Oh,
we have our sponsor. Give him a shout out, Chris Clay. Tell him what we got on the show today, sir.
Nico V. Wine. Brought to you by my man Money Banks.
What's going on?
AKA 06.
Drinking mines right now.
Yeah, I'm, you know what I'm saying?
I got
a little
something
frosty.
You got bottles for the night.
Just went up by like 200.
The king is the real Kang.
The Kang is here with the content Kang.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And we're doing another slide through. Shout out to everybody tuning in, whether you be on, whatever you be on, however you heard us. We want to give a shout out to y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When the classes around here, man, what's going on, fellas? How was the weekend? How was going on? You know, I'm kind of supercharged because you know tomorrow's my day. I'm going to tell y'all right now, again, if you didn't see the Kanye doc, check it out.
Did you finish it?
Yes. Kanye doc.
Listen, really?
Listen. You don't have to, right now, even if you don't fuck with Kanye, you gotta see the doc because it shows you the fell in love with musically back then.
That's cool, and you start to realize why he is.
And I don't know anyone that can watch that documentary and come out and say he's not a musical genius.
My thing is this.
Absolutely 100% genius.
It is the epitome of speaking things into existence. If you know them people you're speaking things into existence, like you literally get a chance to see Kanye before his jaw broke, before the car accident.
Yo,
you see what I'm saying?
Yo, that's when the Kanye
accident.
You gotta watch it.
Kanye to me is like Terrell Owens, just hearing him talk gets on my nerves, but he's a genius, and genius got weirdness with it, and I just don't have the patience for him. But I said like this, I have to fuck with Kanye since the
beginning.
When I watched it, it made me say, even though I don't like the new shit, it did just make me say, let me just see what Kanye's talking about.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Let me see. Yeah. Even though I still don't like the new sound, whatever they be talking about, you know, he hits on the 3, not the 4 sometimes and shit, all that obvious shit that I'm supposed to make sense to me, it don't. So I don't get it. I maybe don't have the ear, but as far as a documentary, it's good shit. Say if you get the docs, like this is just do the whole documentary thing, period. Like if you just in documentaries, you know what I'm saying? If you're in the documentaries, you're gonna love it because actually, it's shot like a series.
Listen.
So it's pretty much 2.5 hours each episode.
Yes.
So you know what I mean?
It's 3 episodes.
When I tell you,
like he said, if you're into documentaries, this one is so pure though, because it's not, I'm gonna do a documentary of what he said. We're gonna start documenting it right now.
How about this, Banks? Let me give you a parallel.
Before he was nothing.
What you got going on right now? See, okay, you know you're in the wine business, okay? Say that you decided from day one. From day one, you know what I'm saying? You are hooked on this wine game. So say from day one, just like, you know, from your interviews when you were saying
from
that
06.
You were trying to figure out the recipes, you just said
from 06.
Man, let me put a camera in my face. And then everybody sees you from your first bottle. And talking just like basically putting the camera in your face and you're just saying, man, I think I'm gonna sell wine. You see what I'm saying? Right. And everybody's like, what the fuck you talking about? Right. You know what I'm saying?
Dog.
And it gets up to where we are today. I'm a peep it. But I'm gonna say this.
Listen, move on. Because you gotta see it. And you'll realize after the first one. Matter of fact, I'm gonna tell you probably within the first half hour, you're gonna be like, oh shit, I see what they were saying.
Yeah.
Because it's that genius.
He's a genius. I fuck with that Kanye.
I don't
fuck with the business. I understand he's a great business. I'm never gonna knock him, but I think he's great as fuck. And when you're chasing, you just look all the way bad to me. That takes away a lot to me. I don't give a fuck with
even,
you.
But when you watch the documentary, you're gonna see when it got to this point. Because it goes all the way up to about last year. Mm-hmm. Listen, wait till you see it. You're going to see the faces. You're like, this is the Kanye I fell in love with. Oh, that's the one
you can literally see it. Even with her at all.
Wait till you see it. Matter of fact, you gotta come back.
We all know that guy.
You gotta come back.
We all know that guy.
You gotta come back.
My thing is this. We can get out of that. This try it out. It's on, what is it, on Netflix, Chris?
I'm gonna peep it.
It's on Netflix.
Yeah.
If you watch the first one, you're gonna definitely binge watch.
You're
definitely gonna binge
watch. He got knowledge. I'm not knocking it. As long as it's that old Kanye, even when his jaw's real big and he's humble, I love that.
I'm trying to tell you, if you ask anybody.
Shout out to that Kanye.
I ain't been a Kanye dude in a minute. And my girl told me about the documentary. She was like, we should watch it. And then Smoke told me, watch the first episode. And I'm like, oh yeah. And I checked it and I was like, oh wow. Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to say it like this. Now we're about to go into y'all. I'm about to get into y'all yard because we're about to do a follow-up story because last week we was talking about the quarterback situation and the gentleman from the Titans.
Yes.
I see that he's not going to get charged.
From the Texans.
Yes. I see he's not going to get charged.
No criminal charges.
So let's give a shout out to that.
That was billionaires playing chess, trying to put that kid in the place like, I'll take it from you.
Boy, you better stay in your place.
Yes. Because he spoke out against the owner. And listen, if the man did it, he deserves whatever it is. But for it to come back 22... And no criminal case.
22 all about money?
And no, yeah, following up with civil.
All civil's bread.
So,
not criminal.
None of that. That went to the grand jury.
Hey, sounds more of a like a
the
setup.
Grand jury.
That means it was a thorough investigation.
The grand
sounds more
jury
like a setup.
Said,
like, I'm going to destroy you,
no
your
criminal
name.
Criminal charges yeah. that can
destroy your whole person.
Yes.
So, okay, so.
That shit happens. It happens all the time. Yeah. There are athletes who do these things and all that, but this case doesn't look to be like a case.
So what is it?
Never had a track record.
Yeah,
and not even a little bit. Like he was talking about earlier before we started recording, and we were saying how good of a kid Sky Moore is. that. You know what I mean? Since a little kid, nothing. And then all of a sudden, after he speaks out against a billionaire owner and says he don't like how he conducts his business because there was rumors of racism from their owner.
There wasn't rumors.
Facts.
Owner was saying something. He said something about the prison. Yeah. Prisoners are running the prison.
Yeah.
Something like
that. The prisoners can't let the prisoners run the yard.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So he was like, I went out of here. I'm not trying to be here. I'm not. They traded my best player
for nothing.
For peanuts. And now he's talking like, I went out of here. And then very shortly after all this happens, and it's your lawyer. Under the billionaire's lawyer. Mm. If that ain't funny,
I know. He's trying to destroy
his character.
I seen that. That was the billionaire's owner not too long ago. I don't know how true it is, but I know that him and the lawyer had a relationship. Whether he was his lawyer or his friend, it was something. You know what I mean? And for 20 of the 22 were all
represented by him.
And all these other masseuse that had masseused them, like through the teams and everything, said no. And listen, they're talking about massage therapy place, and no sexual intercourse type shit. Come on, man.
So I'm gonna ask you a question.
Come on,
not
man.
Not one.
The owner of the Patriots got caught up
getting head
at a massage therapist. That shit went right under the rug.
They spoke about that shit,
gave him a fine.
Gave it to this good man, sweet.
Billionaire, they gave him like a couple hundred million fine.
They made excuses. His wife's dead. What can he do? You're hearing that shit.
So bringing this home, how's this going to affect this gentleman in the future as far as the NFL? Is anybody looking at him? He's going to get suspended.
He's going to get suspended. Ben did four. He'll do 4 to 6.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They're saying right now 8, appeal 6.
Yeah, I'm saying, yeah. End of day,
but listen,
4 to 6.
Smoke, let me break it down to you. Because I know you're not big on the football now, but I know at the time you was. I'll go to the grave. No one can ever question. This dude has been a Kansas City fan since Christian Okoye. He thought he was Christian Okoye.
Nigerian nightmare. My brother from Nigeria.
Listen. When Smoke was overweight and he was trying to, he thought he was Christian Okoye, right? Listen.
He's going on the internet.
No. Listen. Let me get why. I'm gonna show you why. So he's a Kansas City fan. True. You know what I mean?
We have Andy Reid now. Yes.
That's his team. Listen. Patrick Mahomes, right?
Right.
If Patrick Mahomes is 1A, Watson is 1B. He's that good.
Okay.
His coach in college at Clemson said he's the Michael Jordan of football. That's what he told him.
And listen,
as he's played every year, he hasn't, since he was a rookie, he's been amazing, like on Mahomes level. Mahomes got the Super Bowl, you know what I mean? So, to put it in perspective, that's where I'm telling you, that's where this kid is.
So somebody's going to pick him up.
This is what happened.
Listen, he talked to the Falcons, Saints, Panthers, Browns. So those are the four teams.
Out of those four, what four you said? You said it was the Browns,
Panthers,
Panthers, Falcons, Saints.
It's Falcons or Saints.
He ain't going to Cleveland. He ain't going to Carolina.
Listen.
It's either Falcons or Saints.
He's going to Atlanta.
Hey, they said Atlanta.
Them Southern boys like to stay home. That's why that's why Jameis Winston wouldn't come here. You know what I mean? Like I that's who I wanted to come for the Steelers. But he ain't leaving the South.
So,
Baker's going to the coast.
Baker's
going to the coast.
Baker says goodbye to Cleveland. They're going to sign this off.
Hold on, Rich. Listen, to end up on that Watson, because that's the biggest story here.
He might have
but Rich,
what?
I mean, going. Rich, smoke. So, since no criminal charges.
Right.
And it's crazy, because like I said, the owner's playing chess. No criminal charges, right? The owner said, Watson has a trade clause. He doesn't have to go to any team. When he signed a big contract. He's paid. And they paid. This is how you know it was crazy, Smoke. They paid him last year not to play. Wow. Just come to practice, and you're not playing all year. But we're paying you to play, and he has one of the biggest contracts in the NFL.
Stay in shape, basically.
But listen, so this is how it's chess. The owner now, he got a trade clause, so he can pick where he wants to go. The owner says, listen. Don't even come talk to me unless you're talking about 3 first round picks, 3 second round picks, and whoever I want on your roster. That's that. Like, I'm being honest. I'm going to be honest. Like, the Steelers, I'm not even going to lie. If Deshaun Watson, if they came and said, I'm not even going to lie, and people might hate me for this, if they said, give me Kirkpatrick. Bye. Fitzpatrick. Bye. Listen. Cam, I love you to death. Bye. TJ fucking won.
What?
Bye.
Real quick.
Listen. You know why? No, I'm not saying all together. I'm saying one. You know why, TJ?
I got you, Chris. Hold on.
You know why, TJ?
Real quick.
You can get... I'm not saying you can get someone as good as TJ.
Get the wine from this guy.
You can't get another Deshaun Watson.
Listen, all I'm going to say like this. Thoughts and prayers
ain't
to
no
the brother.
That man would stay.
And that's what's up. He beat the case. And hopefully you have a hell of a future.
They going to jail.
So therefore, no, we're here. Yeah, you just rushed. You just rushed it. So a lot of things is going on the weekend in the NFL.
Right.
So obviously, it's easy for me to ask this as a group question because we all have the same team. So I want to know what's going on with you guys' team. It's all pretty much Steeler fans, right? So who are you guys is looking at? What moves are you just trying to make on the offseason? We'll just go around the
board. If I can finish with the Watson, I would have did the Watson.
I want to ask that question right there, sir.
No, what? What
is your team doing on the offseason to get better?
The Steelers? Yeah. We signed some key offensive linemen, man. We had to get the inside or interior line beef. Same. We did that. Trubisky. I thought Trubisky sucked. When I first heard it, I thought it sucked. Because I wanted Winston, so I thought it sucked. But then once I thought about it, he's not too bad. Like, with a good team, with a good coach,
he's
going to play up.
Right.
Now, one thing I would say about the Steelers, right? They can get somebody from fucking DeVry, and they'll end up being the shit. They'll get it from fucking Art Institute of Pittsburgh, and they'll end up being you know what I'm saying? They'll end up being the best goddamn middleweight in the damn league and shit. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I said middleweight. I said middle linebacker, you know what I'm saying? We just picked him up for our institute, you know what I'm saying? He ends up being the best quarterback in the league. You know what I'm saying? So I always have faith
and the Steelers drafting is for what it's worth. So you said local, you still can kind of
put. Oh, you give up Minka and TJ?
No, not together.
Let's get Minka and Cam and draft picks all day.
See, you wouldn't those are how many spots you would have to replace just
bro,
for one
Cam's
talent.
32, you're giving away. Years old,
listen,
bro.
I'm saying one of them.
Are we talking about Cam Newton?
Cam Hayward.
Ripped up Cam Hayward bag.
Oh, wow.
He's one of the best defensive linemen.
He is, but listen, you can only pay one defensive lineman. You can only pay one linebacker, one defensive back. Two is getting money, too. You can only pay one defensive lineman.
Right.
I mean, I'd trade Hayward. I would do that. Dog. You know what I mean? Minka, now, I'd be upset with Minka being gone, but to get Deshaun, if we be a contender every fucking year with Deshaun. Deshaun's 26. For the next 7 years, we're in the hunt. 8 years, we're in the hunt.
Yes.
Deep in the hunt.
Super Bowl.
Yeah, every year.
Super Bowl.
So without
Deshaun's that nice.
They said we can do that. We can get rid of a Minka. I just saw something. I was looking at getting a honey badger. Get rid of Minka, get the honey badger. I just saw that. I just posted that on my Facebook. I get the honey badger. You want to fuck with the honey badger?
No, I fuck with the honey badger. Big. I'm just saying, anybody on the roster right now?
Not TJ. You're saying swapping one for one.
The room?
No. Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you this.
Because I could have.
TJ, tell me, TJ for Mahomes.
It's a different topic.
TJ for Mahomes.
It's a different topic.
Who?
Look at the Rooney.
Let me ask you this, though.
Look at the Rooney's. The Rooney's stand behind their white boy. All day.
I'm talking
TJ
about
what?
Is I'm there, talking about
well, I'm just telling you. That's why I'm telling you it's never going to happen.
But I'm talking about
I'm telling you this never.
Is he there what? This quarterback?
No, he's a linebacker.
Look,
Ben is
going.
Ben is going. So the best white boy
just signed
on the team
another big contract.
Is TJ Watt. He's the one who still
Wait, hold on.
Just signed another big contract with TJ.
Yes. Hold on.
Hold on, that's what Rooney thinks.
One second.
Let's see. He's the strongest league over.
No, he's not. He went to say so.
The Kang was all over. Would you steal or talk?
What's your thought?
Would you give up TJ?
Hey, smoking and I follow Rich. No, I would not give up TJ. That's not happening.
Listen. I'll put it this way, though.
It would definitely be on top of Baltimore for the next 10 years.
If we had the Sean Watson. If we had to some
coke, Chris. Dante Dawson, Claypool, Washington, and Pauly, Juju again, and don't forget about.
Juju's going.
Don't forget about. Don't forget about Harris.
And that's one of
the defense. Juju's going. Listen,
we cooking right now, and it's on the sports. I'm going to ask one catch question before we move on to all these Steeler fans right here, okay? So, let me ask you a question. Let me finish my question, too. If next year...
Is that a question or questions?
Listen.
It's going to be a stat question.
Listen.
That's why I'm asking right now, because I already know.
Okay, so listen. If Deshaun Watson was the quarterback of the Steelers next year, everybody is on the roster except for TJ Watt.
No.
Are they a Super Bowl contender?
Listen, it's a loaded question.
Stop. Stop. Don't shoot Trubisky. Right? No. We got Mitchell Trubisky on our team.
Right now.
Right. Next year, we got TJ Watt and Mitchell Trubisky on our team. Be honest, Steeler fans. Are we a Super Bowl contender?
They could be. They could be contenders.
They could be.
Money?
You want seven.
Listen. You don't need an extraordinary quarterback,
bro,
to get to the Super Bowl.
Smoke.
Although having one is a great thing.
Right.
It's to your advantage. But I'm gonna tell you what, man.
I'm not getting it.
I'm telling you what. Numbers don't lie, man. Defenses win these fucking games. If there ain't no defense, this offense is gonna shoot up and down the field all goddamn day.
Because I know that Pittsburgh is known for their fucking defense. Look,
Curry, they don't.
Listen. It's not like we're getting a rookie quarterback.
Listen.
Your number one defense and to keep your line and everything you got right now?
Yo, hey, listen.
You're saying they can't?
Listen.
This ain't gonna work.
Listen. Yo, it's like this.
You're saying they can't. It's impossible. But if he comes there, that's everything. We're contenders now.
No, listen.
And that's all we should be carried about. I don't give a fuck what we gotta do to get rid of him. Because you're not. He's trying to make it seem like it would be a one for one trade. We all know it would not be like
our
that.
Defense,
you're giving more
same.
Than that. They won draft picks.
Listen, bro.
They won draft picks.
Okay. Let me say
so these are nothing.
Let me say
three
something.
Number ones. Two no, number two.
If you give up TJ Watt, you're not giving up three number ones, though.
Let me tell you something real quick, man. Listen.
Nigga, say it.
Mitchell Trubisky was 29 and 21 with the Bears. He went to the Pro Bowl in 2018.
This is a quarterback.
This is the quarterback.
Listen, with the Bears.
Sure
he got a 10-8 game. He's over the Bears. Now, he's coming.
Trubisky for a long haul.
Now, he's coming to Pittsburgh.
That's stupid.
Trubisky comes out to talk.
He just left the Bills. He definitely need a whole new environment. It be something because we got receivers, offense, we got a defense. And so it might be
Hold on, one question. Who was Buffalo's offensive line coach when he was there in Buffalo? Who was his offensive weapons he had back there?
He was on the bench.
He was on the bench.
So he didn't have nobody. He was on the bench. He was the backup.
And I like the kid. But he's not fucking Deshaun Watson.
Nobody tried to say he was Deshaun. I'll get my talk after Mark. I'm trying to say that you said they wouldn't be contenders. You're saying that I said he was a Deshaun Johnson. No, I can't. I mean, Deshaun, hold on. See, this is what they talk about, folks, when the media puts words in your mouth.
Hey, if your boy Fat was here, he would call him to bitch.
I'm just trying to make it seem silly. I'm just not trading Watt in his prime. Hey, like, I'm looking at as a
prime
owner,
and pride.
Bro, as the owner.
Prime and pride.
But as the owner of the Steelers, I'm looking at, because I own shit now, bro. I look at shit like that way. I'm telling you, I'm looking as a Rooney. If I'm a Rooney, the way the Rooneys do it, they got their white dude. You know what I mean? They keep one. And what is that face? He sells jerseys. He gets people in.
You're thinking as a business. I'm telling you. You're putting your CEO hat on. And he's talking about rings.
I'm talking about rings too. I'm talking about rings too. Because it's like this.
Ask him.
Listen, Carl, fam. With Trubisky, your team. It's found.
Yo, the new Nike Trubisky.
Your team as a whole is bounced. I'm going to tell you why. Because on defense, you have that pass rusher. And what? Defense wins championships. Yeah. Pittsburgh is known to be a defense. Listen, hold on. I'm done.
You're a coach.
Now look. Okay. Financially, look at Watson's contract. He's making $100 million. Alright? Him and Watt's contracts would wash each other out. I get that. But it fucks up our defense so much with our pass rush, bro. He's our main pass rusher. That's what the fuck we do. You don't just find those guys. Those guys are expensive too. So to replace him, we're not gonna ask him.
Is this guy like in the locker room, some type of Lawrence Taylor?
Deshaun's a great guy.
No, I'm talking about the charity. I'm just saying, as far as who he means to the team.
That's a tough sell. He's the Rooney.
I'm picturing him as the guy that gets the guys in the circle.
Look, right?
He's that dude. He can do that. They can't stop him.
Is he a team captain?
Listen.
Yes, absolutely.
On that defense.
As a Rooney, I'm telling you. As a Rooney.
I'm just saying, how about asking how it would hurt the morale if this guy leaving to the other player?
He's the best defensive player. He should have won defensive player of the year.
We need to have chemistry.
He is the defensive player of the year this year. Best defensive player of the year.
The best of the best.
Yeah.
The best of what we have to offer.
And Smoke, as a Rooney, like I was talking about, the picture with United Way with UPMC with the crippled kid, TJ Watt. That's what it is.
He meant handicapable.
And that's what I meant. That's why I didn't mean no disrespect to anybody. But you understand what I'm saying? That sells to the Roonies. You understand? It's about that. It's about sponsorships. We're the fans, we sit in the seats, but what it's about is the little plaster things that sit with sponsorships. We come in with $300 to spend, bro.
You know what I mean? And we're going to spend it because we love the Steelers. That motherfucker on the wall spent $6 million. Get on the wall.
My thing is,
we don't need a dude. Why? We don't want the dude that looked like he just raped 20 kids, 20 women.
So you're basically saying, in a nutshell, this skin is a sin. Because that's what I'm going to ask you. Why can't he be the face of that?
He was.
The same way old Bradshaw had to be. We don't do that. That's what we don't do here.
Mahomes. We just talked about Mahomes. He's a black. He carries his team. He's the face of his team. So are you compartmentalizing saying, well, the Rooneys act like this or the NFL?
No. The Rooneys are great folks as far as hiring and all that. They got Rooney rules. I'm saying, but in our particular, what we're looking for in a quarterback, we look for the Big Ben model, 6'5" white dude. And it's a smart corn model. Fed. It's a smart model because it works.
Looks like
Ben.
a good old boy.
Yeah.
Strong arm, it's smart. I want you to stay in the pocket.
It worked for Ben. Yeah. But what other quarterback have they found since Landry Jones, Tony Maddox?
No one.
Brian St. Pierre.
Forgot all about him.
Look, they're all 6'5".
Yeah, one guy from Bit Player, Alex.
Van Pelt, he was decent.
St. Pierre was.
I fuck with Van Pelt.
Alex Van Pelt.
I fuck with Van
Chris Clay.
Listen. Uh-oh. So it's my turn.
To come up with the candles.
Y'all niggas, shit. I'm just telling you, bro.
I'm sorry.
You go ahead.
Eddie hit his Googles.
Go ahead.
No.
Cool fact checks. Here we go.
I love Deshaun Watson.
So, I'll start with Pop. He talked about Trubisky. He thought Trubisky was winning all them games in Buffalo. Listen, I like the pickup. He's not Deshaun Watson.
He's not.
So, let me talk. When they would have gave up a trade.
Hold on, real quick. That's an interject. Okay, hold on. Big Ben is not a Mahomes, but he still got rings.
So, when you talk about giving up everything, if it was, I'm saying me as an owner, if it's Deshaun Watson and why, and you're trading, you're not going to give up all those other draft picks too. It's gonna even out more. We all know that at the table. If that's what it was.
It's not gonna.
So listen. Okay. So then. I'm done. With Pop. So I disagree.
Because he's not winning.
The Kang.
The Kang. So get the little rich. This guy just talked about Trubisky, right? 10 hours ago, he was on Facebook killing Trubisky. All the quarterbacks, that's what we got. Why didn't we get Deshaun Watson? I'm on Facebook, Smoke. Facebook.
4,300 friends of yours.
I'm not going to waste another second.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah, we can move on.
Yeah. This guy.
And Little Rich is not in his head, like, you know, I need to shut my mic off.
So, 06.
No. Rich said on the mic that you need to shut your mic off.
Listen.
Just tell him. No, just lean in. You don't got to grab it.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Little Rich, this guy. 06. My man, Money Banks.
Hey, don't say too much. You know he's our sponsor now. We don't need to get cut off. We don't
want
to get cut off here now. I'll get too fucking spicy over there.
Listen.
Okay.
He had the best argument. For sure.
He was talking. He was putting out some shit. Hey, Smokey, as you would say, he was cooking.
But it comes down to this. You like more defense. You like what we've done over the offseason, right? You signed the corner. Everybody Tyson's coming back.
Let's try to swing coming back. Decision.
We got the boy on the other side of Watt, who's an up and coming guy. Just signed a corner. Got Sutton. Signed the other corner. Got Kirk. We got Fitzpatrick.
Where's he going with this smoke?
I'm gonna take you there.
This guy is dragging
I'm gonna take you there. I'm gonna take you there right now.
I don't know about you.
So listen. I asked you earlier. So if I remove Watt from the team, right? And I add Watson.
You're a darn.
And everything on. Listen.
That's what
the roster of everybody's
everybody
signed.
Look up you like
listen, everybody else is signed. Everybody on the defense who are legit. Top five in their positions. Right? The only one you're giving up is Watt. And he's fucking amazing. Because he set the all-time
you're
record.
A clown, sir.
Listen. So, with Mitchell Trubisky.
Watch out,
be honest. Is Mitchell Trubisky going to Kansas City and beating Mahomes?
Listen,
I'm not done. Is Mitchell Trubisky going down the road to Cincinnati and beating Burrows and the boy Chase?
Like, the comparison's in the wrong spot.
Wait, can I talk now?
We give up.
Listen, we got 10 minutes. We're going to get out of this.
Yeah, we're getting out of here. I shut up for all of you.
9 o'clock, 2 minutes, Chris.
I shut up for all of you. Put me on the clock, Smoke. I shut up for all you guys.
I'm about to answer.
And you tell me if Trubisky can beat any of those guys. We're talking about removing one guy from the defense and adding a franchise quarterback.
Is he a franchise middle back?
Defense wins championships right
now.
Defense wins championships.
Yes.
Who won the Super Bowl this year?
Leaving something out though.
The Rams. Yeah. What did they do in the offseason? They brought in a franchise quarterback. They already had the best defense in the league. And they were losing.
He's leaving out there.
Tom Brady.
Listen.
Leave every fucking year because he's the fucking franchise quarterback!
You said you shut your mic off. You are done, sir. When he's leaving out, he made a great point. Great points. I love Deshaun Watson, but Smoke, what he's missing out is this. It's a one for one, right? Deshaun Watson still makes more money in his contract. TJ Watt. Okay? Again, with my suit and tie, so I'm looking at it. We still owe him more money, so guess what? We don't go get the lineman that we just got. Because we don't got the money. So, Deshaun Watson, as great as he is not going to go into KC next year and do good. Because why? Because we don't have those great linemen that we just got. We got the same bum-ass line from last year.
They're going to be chasing it down.
You understand? Listen. If we sign Deshaun Watson... If we sign Deshaun Watson and give him his money, That means he made more money than TJ. So that means we got, listen. That enough that we wouldn't go.
Jeff went up.
Listen,
we already know.
Trevor, Dimitar.
This crack is cooking.
Enough. We wouldn't have got that lineman from the Bears. We wouldn't have got that lineman from the Bears. We wouldn't have got that lineman from the Bears. We wouldn't have just got him.
They got all them boys for cheap, dog.
No, we didn't. We spent some money on him.
Sure, we're straight, brother. You know what I'm saying?
$20 million? Nah, we got him for like $20 million.
Schultz, we spent money on him. That's the only one we spent big money on the line. And that's what we're spending
$14 million on Trubinsky. We spent money in other places to make the team whole. Because again,
we have to balance.
Yeah, man, you got a lot of people to pay. And if we sign Watson, salary cap issues, we'd have them.
Like to have, but, you know.
And in 2 years, that nigga's making like $80 million a year.
That's a big thing.
Years.
I still don't understand how all this little salary cap going to be. Stuff, you know,
the salary cap went up, bro.
Not with all the people
dude,
that were paying.
Didn't get paid like that.
Who didn't?
That lineman you're talking about, he didn't get paid.
At the end of the day.
3 years, $7 million.
Look, guys.
That's pennies.
At the end of the day.
$7 million. Look at the cap. Look at the whole cap.
Guys, it's been a half hour on this
conversation.
We got other things on the docket.
You gotta look at the whole, you gotta look at the team, man. I love Deshaun Watson. I wish we got him. I would give all the draft picks for him. I would give Minka.
This settles it for me. When I ask if you have a better chance winning the Super Bowl next year with the roster and Watson on it, what do you have a better chance with him or Trubisky? Watson. Even with Watt off the team.
We're a solid contender with him.
Last word is yours, sir.
We're a contender with Trubisky, and for the next 5 years, we're good. With Watt, our salary cap's gonna be fucked up because that motherfucker's gonna be making $38 million a year and shit like that. He got a crazy contract.
Hey, Paco, hold on. That's it.
There's like four quarterbacks now. Big contract.
Politics. Now we're gonna have to say Steeler Talk is a part of that too now. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Hey, Pop.
Especially when you got a bunch of Steelers.
Hey, Pop. Y'all supposed to be on the same page. Y'all beeping like Buzz and Chris.
No, we love the same team.
Shout out to my guys.
We don't beat down like that arrowhead.
Hey, Rocky, we're gonna change the mood a little bit. I seen you put something about a legend that's coming back rapping KRS-One, and I've been like, no, I've been scruffy. I see, because y'all don't understand, I followed something. Another legend that's probably trumping this guy, and he came with some shit.
Pastor Mace.
First of all, what are you guys thinking about that song?
The delivery's nice, man. I like it, man. The flow, the tempo, everything. The music selection, the beat, everything was on.
Yeah.
I like
it. You agree?
I think Mace is silly, though.
I'm gonna say, since we talked about KRS first, right?
Yeah, you got KRS.
I was baiting you guys.
Yeah, yeah,
Cavs. Cavs won and made.
I was like, oh, I know, but
not even in the same room.
You're right.
Yeah. Hey, you got me.
Yeah.
Hey, listen.
That's what we're designed to do.
You're right.
I've been tuned into with that Cavs since he posted that. I've been looking at some shit because when I went on there.
But let's stick with the Mace.
Yeah. So he's doing his thing. Cavs still a killer.
For sure.
They killed that right there.
He did.
But what I'm saying is, what he just did right there, he can play for these young cats. Because he's on that, like the way he was spitting it and shit, you know what I mean? It's like what they listen to already.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That shit's like a relevant type shit right now. Like, if you put on Karis One, all of us in here are going to be like, oh, yeah, that shit hard. That right there, the younger crowd, I think they would never have
to. I'm going to tell you like this. I think that song is fucking trash.
I thought it was garbage.
You know what I'm saying? I don't like auto-tune Mace. And then also, that's what I really want to talk about right there. Is how many years are you going to be talking about Puffy owing you money? You know what I'm saying? Until you lawyer up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, your lawyer game sucks.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because
fuck, man.
You know what I mean? Like until you look like this has been over 20 years.
Mm-hmm. 20.
You know what I'm saying? And then we all heard like when you know when 50 Cent tried to buy Mace out and they said, you know what? Puffy wanted $2 million, and 50 said that Mace ain't worth $2 million with $2 million in his pocket. You know what I'm saying? Like, so my thing is this. We, you know what I'm saying? We can be privy to, we don't know a lot about business, and I can refer to Banks about this, but like, I just think that, and I heard somebody else say this, it might have been on the Joe Budden podcast. Somebody said that if Mace had something, any respective lawyer would just pick up the case. If you had something, you know what I'm saying? And also, just because you think something, just because you think somebody owes you something, doesn't mean it. Now, okay, we can talk about, okay, we can say like this. So, I think that I can speak about this because it might come to home. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of local artists, right? May see, okay, a person looks at you and looks at the talent in the person, right? And sometimes a person might think it's out of love, okay? But it's out of business. I can put you in a position to make money, and that, you know what I'm saying? So we can kind of make money off each other. It's not the fact that we're friends. And that's...
Go ahead. Because my opinion on it, Mace, after Biggie died, Mace wrote everything and kept Bad Boy going.
Right.
So I think more he feels he's owed more because of that. But you got paid for the shit that you was writing. You signed what the fuck you signed to get paid.
And President says, we can talk about NBA Youngboy. I was talking about he don't get no money off of YouTube and none of that. And we can probably talk about somebody else. We're going to put this on one thing. Because if you took it, you got to understand what that's against. You see what I'm saying? So, okay. People might say Puffy was wrong for saying that. You know what?
Here's $100,000. Find a way to publish it.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? If Puffy didn't do anything wrong.
You signed the wrong deal. You signed the wrong deal. And he was fucked up for having you sign that deal or whatever. But maybe Puffy didn't think it was going to be this big either. But honestly, that's up to you to still have your lawyer there.
Now let me throw the curveball at you. Now if you're look it that way. Okay, he doesn't know that. So when you get signed to a label, Puffy comes into his label. Let's not even put it on Puffy. This is put on any label executive and artist. You might think as an artist, Carter label. Because you see what I'm saying? Because I work for you. So he obviously has to be working for me. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that thing, that's when they get it twisted.
Like perfect
you
example.
You see what I'm saying, Chris?
Perfect example. With Puffy and Sean. Sean busted the gun. Puffy brought our lawyer. But our lawyer is to help Bad Boy. Who is Bad Boy? Puffy.
Right. Yeah, he took that even.
Who the fuck went to jail?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, because he.
You know what I'm saying? So when an artist goes in with the company lawyer, they think, oh, I got a lawyer. It's coming. No, the lawyer's there for the company.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Yeah. I can help you, but
yeah.
At the end of the day, that's who pays.
As long as I protect these guys, that's on.
Yeah, I got you some money. I am your lawyer as well, but I'm Bad Boy. I'm supposed to get Bad Boy a shitload of money, and that's what I did.
Okay, now let's talk about this. About the go in. Now let's like you, the field you're in and the field you're in, right? Okay, you were taught a certain way. Okay, now maybe after you're just doing things yourself, you're saying, hey man, it was working, but it wasn't the right way. You see what I'm saying? So what I'm trying to say is, maybe that's the way Puff Daddy was taught. You see what I'm saying? He's only going, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like a school. How we learn in school, this is what I know. Because I only know one executive, because this is what I'm trying to say. Because the lawyer is there to protect you. And the only person I know that did that was Dame Dash. When he said, the lawyer came to him and said, what? I got their publishing? No, I don't want all this shit. Give him that shit back. When he was under Aboriginal Flavor. Because the lawyer is there to protect you. So they're just going up by the standard contract with his already standard. They're just cutting and pasting what the contract is. That's what it is.
Okay. Like, just from my experience, from, like, dealing with people in the entertainment line, I can see that, my humble opinion, with people in the entertainment game, there's rappers on TV and stuff, them are just niggas who made it. You understand? They're still niggas. They move like we move on the bottom. They just money. Right. The mentality is exactly.
I'm a win. I'm a
win with whoever I'm dealing with, but they're in a better position because they're in the game. You're trying to get in the game. The game is about hustling. I'ma hustle the fuck out this dude. I'ma spin him as much as I can to get as much bread out of him. Cause that's what we do on the block.
So basically, you said Puffy's the plug. Period.
There's gatekeepers all over the place. He's not the only one. You know what I mean? He's not the only one. But yeah, you gotta.
Okay, and I'll use that. And speaking of money, because when Apocalypse was on his list, one of his worst rappers, because we did the worst rapper list last week. Tekashi 6ix9ine comes out and says he's broke. He has no money.
He just said?
Yeah, he just came out a couple days ago. His manager, WAP 100, said he had to send him $20 for gas.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
$20?
$20 for gas. Now, I don't know which way I want to take this conversation, because we could rehash about what we talked about last week, about how the street shit cats is profit. Well, I'll just take it there. We can assume, you know what I'm saying, and I don't think he's broke to their standard or our standard. You know what I'm saying? But he's broke to their standard.
If he's asking for 20.
Hold on, let me give you some backstory. He does got some, you know, he had a court case.
I'm sure
he got a court case, and he has some restitution coming up. So he played the whole, I'm broke, and you know what I'm saying?
Tell
I ain't got
what,
no.
That security detail is a big chunk of that change.
That's
just gone.
Thank you, sir. And that's what I'm saying.
The security detail ate him alive.
Not only that, man.
So now that's wearing out. Now where does that take him?
But think about everything the label got that he's not with. They recouped all that shit.
Yeah. A lot of times, that's what I was saying. He was unrecouped because I think he sounded like a 10,000 song deal or some shit.
Damn.
Something like that.
Damn.
And he signed directly with Universal. Like Lucian, he signed with his son, so he's directly. But I look at it this way, and y'all can walk with me. I think that I honestly think, and you know, I don't think that some of these youngins are into the music. I think they're into the story. You see what I'm saying? They're looking to who kills next. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They don't really give a fuck about. Yeah. And they I think that once he took the stand, that kind of, even though we knew who he was, the kids didn't know who he was. So once he did that, it was like, oh, you ain't sliding on nothing because you going to tell. So you can't talk this gangster shit to Lil Durk in him because you're going to tell. No, because even he made horrible music. Trash. But even though the thought that him, that the perception, hanging around with them gentlemen that perceived to be gang members, you see what I'm saying? I think that the image of him is diminished. And then just like he said, Rocky said, the overhead. You know what I'm saying? There was
extortion.
But this is after he took the stand. Right. There was a time that he was on live, and the neighbors was like, oh shit, oh, he's our neighbor. And they had to pack it up and move.
Yo,
that cost money.
Right.
24-hour security cost money, and you don't got a hit.
This whole Fed thing. This whole Fed.
And plus the lawyers for that. And the label is probably Vance money.
Again, you know what I'm saying?
And if you ain't recouping,
how many rappers look at their moms after because of that?
And you seen them when he got out? I got $100,000.
That's a lot of them. Yeah, but you know what's gonna happen, though, man. He's gonna, like you said, his brother.
Yeah.
He gonna have a reality TV show.
Okay.
I don't think nobody's gonna buy into it because they get the fight into it now. He's played the troll card, but I'm telling you, he got followed in the bags. You got millions of white kids that still fuck with him. They don't give a fuck that he's a snitch. They're thinking shit. If them motherfuckers came to me and told me I was gonna get fucking 40 years,
that's their plot, and he's the cast. He was saying that's what he was supposed to be. He's still got people, he's still got people that's gonna, you know, he's still got people, and it won't be the quote unquote street guys, because we can just skip past over that, because it's like when Dirk came out and said, hey, or when Future said, hey, Jay-Z might be corporate, but I got the streets.
That's right.
So you're doing that with a Takashi, like, hey man, street cats might not mess with him, but this pocket is a suburban white guy that fuck with this fucking hyper-color hair dude.
They're gonna fuck with him. Because what it is, and it's just fact.
Drama.
Us. When I say us, I mean us.
See that drama.
Us as a culture.
Yeah.
Not just saying black people, but us as a culture.
This is what they do for Empire.
We make you. We make you.
Yeah.
But they take you over top. You know what I'm saying? And he had a point where he was over top. Then we stuck with it.
Right.
But those people that over top, when he puts something, when he do something, they still gonna fuck with you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Nothing is right.
And also, according to, it
shouldn't be like that.
According to the numbers,
right.
I mean,
right.
it's might be. Because
at the end of the day, before you say it, because at the end of the day, like we said, his broke ain't our broke, and we know he wasn't a gangster,
right?
But he came from poverty. You know what I'm saying? He came up as a broke ass kid. Living in the, you know what I'm saying? Even though he wasn't no gangster like he proclaimed. So, you know what I'm saying? So, if he gets his little 15 minutes of fame with a reality TV show that runs for 5 years, you know what I'm saying? He's going to make a couple million dollars.
Listen, they went hand in hand.
You know what I mean? He's always a signature away from a million dollars. He gave the gang his platform as well.
They gave him their platform.
Exactly.
They gave him the pass. They gave him the right to talk. That's what I'm saying.
They stamped him.
But they helped each other with their platforms.
He literally had a motion the head of Universal.
They got the head of
like his son. So you got his son. The head of Universal is probably the biggest record company out there. I mean, biggest video company out there.
Everything comes out of
there. You know what I'm saying? So you have Interscope is under that.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So you have Vivendi is the head of Vivendi is the head company. Universal is under that. So you have the head of Vivendi's son is in love with Tekashi 6ix9ine. And is willing to fucking spend whatever he wants to fucking spend on.
So according to
his point, it's like,
he's allowed to.
If these guys can move to put him in certain situations, they'll make him famous.
Right. It's just like you said.
They'll make him famous.
It's just like you said, Smoke.
Just like Kim Kardashian, she's famous for nothing. She literally does nothing. You know what I'm saying?
If they want to make you, they'll make you. Listen, I'm going to tell you one thing. If he wasn't making money, he wouldn't be where he is right now. So he had to have been making some money.
He's making money for them, but not for him. That's what it is.
But now, there's a lot that comes with that.
Yeah.
There's a lot that comes with that. There's a lot that comes with that.
Like, you know what I'm saying? This is what I'm saying. Them cats that, you know, he snitched on and all that, you know, they probably do want to kill that man. It's not gonna be nowhere. The majority of the motherfuckers ain't flying to California.
He's in a hole.
You know what I mean? Hey, look, Smoke, that's why they like. He gets a lot of clickbait because he be in LA at a club or a Vegas at the club. Listen, motherfuckers ain't coming to Vegas to find you to shoot you. It's not like the whole city's coming after you.
But they made it a point where you came back in the yard. You can't come back in the yard. But don't think that there ain't some of them goons out there that are looking.
What's the chances of them running into you? That's what I'm saying.
I ain't saying the who's coming for you. Yeah. But there'll be them select few that got their little connect.
Random pick number four.
Think about this.
Got their little eyes and ears.
Think about this. He is lesser of Benny the Bull. Benny the Bull moves his shanks, bro.
Sammy the Bull.
Look, moves his shanks. What I'm saying is, and them motherfuckers, to be honest, they got their breads longer than who we're talking about. So if they was trying to go see him, they're not going to fucking California to find Tekashi 6ix9ine to shoot.
I'm not saying that. I'm just talking about they got a few people here that know people there that they can. What I'm saying is, somebody was trying to throw a hat, and I'm not saying the whole thing. What I'm saying is, like this is what I'm saying.
If Tekashi 6ix9ine was from Vandergriff, and Vandergriff was like, say, what Brooklyn was, and he snitched on all the motherfuckers that did all this dirt. So he done snitched all these cats in Vandergriff that did, was on, you know what I mean, did all this
dirt. That is.
Right. And then showed up at Nicky's. He probably gonna get fucking killed.
Wherever that is. Fucking Anthony's.
Wherever that is. I like Anthony. Dude, we're worldwide. I know, but what I'm saying is, we'll put it this way. If he's in Vegas at the Treasure Island, that casino, you know what I'm saying? He's safe there rather than being in Brooklyn at the local bar.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? At the local bar, Paco, he's probably getting his fucking head blown.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But the chances of them running into him are slim to none. He's moving and shaking.
The odds are in their favor. Yeah.
So, you know, that's what I was going to say. Like you said earlier, is it really? Because he just just had that hearing.
Yeah, it might be.
You know, 50 Cent, when they started putting pressure on him about owing somebody, what he do? File bankruptcy. You know what I mean? You want to shake them off you.
But what you saying?
And to be honest, like
that button.
When you talk to these people that have somebody number. They know that's a lot harder than if that happened.
Some of them even said, some of them said very proudly, like, you know, if it doesn't work out,
then I'll
play.
That white truck.
But what I'm saying, they use that though. Whatever, Tekashi 6ix9ine. This is a great question that we've been going out there for years. I mean, not for years, but once, ever since this happened. And the two people want to see going versus Jay-Z or his wife. So,
relax.
I want to give a shout out to Mike and Coop from According to Hip Hop. And I'm gonna see what y'all guys think about this, and then we can definitely have a discussion.
Hold tight.
Let's go.
I'll tell you what, Beyonce catalog ain't that tough, y'all. I know that's controversial. I don't know the Beehive does not want to hear that, whatever. Her catalog's not that tough. I think that Rihanna, Mary J. Blige, and Mariah Carey could beat her in a verse. I'm not even gonna go Janet Jackson. We already know that.
First of all, as far as Janet is concerned, you don't never want that smoke.
No.
You don't never want that smoke. As far as the other three ladies that you are concerned, I think they all would beat her relatively handily.
Because that Destiny Child catalog is even weaker. You're not playing any of those records.
Yo, man, look. Let me tell you, man. Beyonce getting in the game. She's been in like three groups that didn't make it. They kept remaking the group. And look at the songs she's making about needing a man. Like, and then she was independent. And she was confusing her song. Yeah. And there was no bangers. And to me, there was, I don't know a Beyonce banger.
Banks is on his own wire.
I think she's fired, and she's classy, and compared to Whitney, Janet, Mariah Carey, he named Rihanna, she can beat Rihanna. But she's not beating. She's not beating.
That might be the only one she don't beat.
She's not beating Janet Jackson. She's not beating.
Listen, dog.
Mariah Carey. She's not beating them two.
Listen,
she is no way. Mariah Carey got hit.
Bro,
she been up there all night. Mariah Carey has a three year run.
Let's have some order this time. We're gonna start with Chris, and we're gonna go around the horn. Christian. Go ahead and cook.
Can I ask a question before I cook?
So. Go ahead.
Are we talking about a versus?
Yes.
Beyonce gonna need her own group.
Listen. But that's what we're talking about.
It's a versus.
Then listen.
It needs Beyonce, Destiny's Child then.
Dog.
Destiny's Child versus Rihanna then, right?
Dog.
Right?
I'm trying to tell you.
Right?
What?
It'd be the whole group, because she's a crew.
Let me cook.
I'm in your way.
On these verses, they play 20 best songs. Whether it's a feature on it or not, 20 best songs. Oh. Let's go look up the numbers. That Beyonce, what you call it, the Beehive?
Well, Rihanna has an AV.
Yeah, listen. The Beehive is fucking vicious.
Yeah, so it's never and, was this group.
But listen.
The barbs.
But no. But they, like, and
Kirk, give me your top five.
No, you can hold it. No, you can hold it.
Top five Beyonce songs, please.
Listen, 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 listen. You can hold.
Got 25 seconds.
You can hold the Nicki Minaj, and you can hold the Rihanna, and no go fucking toe to toe with Beyonce. But the other ones you're talking about in the verses, they won't. Because what I'm saying, the Beehive, Rihanna's group, them motherfuckers is coming out in waves.
Talking about Chris Kerr's opinion.
Yes. Them motherfuckers is coming out in waves. So, Rihanna, she might not get it. But go look at them numbers and see how many millions and millions and millions
of that fam. We're not talking about that fam.
I'm not talking about my favorite. No, we're talking about who
this is. Sir, this is Darna Cook.
I need to hear Beyonce songs from you. Fuck 20. Fuck 20. I want to hear 5.
Is that what you're
going to
spend your time on?
I want to hear your 5. Your top 5. Man, when I need to hear some Beyonce. I'm going to throw in some Beyonce.
Let's go.
I want to hear them.
Okay, here we go.
Boy, say one.
She can go Bonnie and Clyde.
Jay-Z.
Yes.
Right? That gives a jam to Jack.
Just stop. Just listen. Listen.
Let him dig in.
Listen.
Let him get his claws in there.
To the left. To the left.
Oh.
What?
What's that song? You must not know about me. Is that what it's called?
Oh, God.
Irreplaceable. Yes, that's what it's called. Yeah, good. Irreplaceable.
Irreplaceable.
Need three more, Chris.
She's the best though.
Struggling.
We're talking 20. We're talking 20. Get some five. Listen,
he's on two songs.
Listen, I'm gonna be honest.
We can't do it. The Beehive though.
Yo, it's I'm not part of the Beehive. I'm not part of the Beehive.
But bro, we need 20 for the first.
I don't listen. Listen,
we need 20 for the first.
Listen, what I'm saying.
Chris Kerr has got the two.
No, we all know. I surrender.
I got it.
I surrender. I surrender.
Okay,
I can't name five name wise.
We're talking about your opinion.
Your opinion.
I just said
we're talking about two.
Hold on, man.
Listen, two.
We need 20 to
listen.
Sorry, set your mic off. Thanks, you got 30 seconds.
I didn't know five. I didn't know five.
Therefore,
but that's not me. That's not my favorite.
That's what we're asking you. What is your favorite?
Verses. We're talking about a versus.
You're saying you want to see Beyonce in a versus?
Then give me the five and the only person that will win.
Who emailed Janet Jackson? And Mariah.
Give me five.
Hold on. You want me to play the clip one more time?
Give me five.
I'm going to play the clip one more time.
I can get Janet Jackson.
I'm going to play the clip.
Yeah, we need everybody on the same page here. Name women's songs.
I think Christian can go
there. Bro, I'm not even
saying it. Give me five. Yes.
Rhythm Nation. Control.
This kid, Chris Clay is rocked.
Pleasure Principle. Wait a while. Let's just wait a while before. You know what I'm saying? And that was the fifth one. There's more I can pull out of my pocket. The rhythm name.
Me too. I can pull more out of my pocket.
No, not a Beyonce. You can't.
Where's the five?
You stop. Listen,
bro.
You're on three.
I got the four.
You're on three,
bro.
You said Rhythm Nation twice.
Bro.
He's on three.
Doesn't matter. You said
he made one more than me.
Smoke.
I'm done.
He said Beyonce's name.
I'm not talking again, Smoke.
Kerr said.
I'm not a beehive.
Kerr said.
I know it'll come out buzzing.
Well, might maybe lose to Rihanna, but we'll beat the other ones. Yeah. And he named two fucking songs.
You named three.
No. I didn't say that she was going to lose to the other two, bro. And I didn't say she was going to beat the other two. You said she was going to beat Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
With two songs.
Bro, I'm saying I don't know the name of the songs, just like you don't. I'm saying off of her fan base.
Bro, Kurt.
Off of her fan base.
Okay, I'm talking about, but it's us sitting here, fam. Let's do this.
I'm taking Mary J.
No, fuck that.
I'm taking Mary J.
Fuck with me real quick. You just had a problem with your girl. You getting a whip. You light up a blunt, and you say, yo, I gotta put on a Beyonce song. What Beyonce song do you go to?
You said 411.
What Beyonce song do you go to when you're
riding?
Listen, what about Aaliyah?
What Janet do you go to?
I don't go to Janet at all.
Exactly!
We don't listen to Janet.
I'm talking off of their fan base. In a verse.
I'm done all the time classic.
Okay, listen. We're gonna comprise the list. Look through the slide through. We're gonna do the 20, like the one thing.
And now we got two songs.
We can now let's deal with something we can prove.
You know what I'm saying?
We're gonna deal with something we can prove. Now if you apart,
Rich just woke up.
Missy fucking.
That nigga had his
thumbnails
off over
there. He said Missy.
Miss Elliott. Hey, Smokey. Missy Elliott might be a problem.
She would. She would.
She got more than Beyonce. Missy Elliott might be a problem.
Missy Elliott will be Beyonce. She's the queen. She's labeled the queen because she's married to Jay-Z. That's why she's the queen. I know I'm talking about hits.
Their fan base.
Missy Elliott and Janet Jackson.
That's what Rich is picking right there.
Okay. That's our genre. Because stuff we can prove at this point. So if you reported our slide through group, you know I was tossing some poll questions up in there as far as the game versus Eminem. And I got the results. You know what I'm saying? According to our slide through group. So I'm gonna name the songs. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm gonna tell you who won. And then we'll just add it up and see who won the battle in total. I didn't think I did the full 20. I just did 15. So the first question was, you know, which is a better song? Rap God by The Game. I mean, Rap God by Eminem. You know what I'm saying? Versus The Game, 300 bars.
No way.
Rap God.
Yo, 300 bars is overrated to me. I don't care. I fuck with Game. I do.
These ain't my personal. I take 300 bars.
He's talking about the two jams.
Yeah.
They're coming to the jams. You know, I'm not going by the artist. I'm going by whatever. Yeah, you know, that I'm going by the jam.
That shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
according to the slide through group, with 4-1, Eminem Rap God wins that one. You know what I'm saying? The next one was, you know what I'm saying? Eminem Godzilla featuring Juice WRLD. The Game, Name Me King. You know what I'm saying? Eminem wins that. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
With 2-1.
We need more voters.
Yeah, we need more participation.
Come on, guys.
We need some participation.
Hey, yo, Rich, come on, man.
All you gotta do is hit a button.
Now, yes or no?
That's all you gotta do is hit one button. We're not asking
anyone
any emails.
This is one we'll figure out ourselves because nobody voted on it. Eminem cleaning out my closet or Game running.
I'm not into killing my mom shit. Like the album running. I don't fuck with him.
I wasn't cleaning out my closet, in the same boat as that.
I was mad at my mom from Game Run.
We know we all have faults.
Yeah.
Not to the point where I wanted to
pissed
off.
You don't
like cleaning out my closet?
You was on some crazy.
It's a good song, but it's the poll.
Who wins it? Cleaning out my closet or running by Game? That's the question.
Yeah. So nobody voted, so we can figure it out. In that particular one, though,
I want to go with Clean Up My Closet. I fuck that beat. Yeah.
The beat's hard.
The song.
Right? I just that
I've
beat.
Never been to hurt you.
Yeah. Oh,
going
with Rich. We're running the game.
I like that jam better.
Running wins according to slide through 3-2.
You take running?
Yeah. So that's 3-2. Eminem loses that round. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nobody,
tomato, tomato.
Yeah. Okay. All right. This,
we need more participation.
M, Superman, and Game wouldn't get too far.
Wouldn't get too far. I love
it. Wouldn't really matter. So we got voters on this one. So, no, according to, we're only going by the slide through group. According to the slide through group, Eminem wins it with 2 votes. And we, you know what I'm saying?
This
and wouldn't get too far, loses with 1.
The very good our group.
No.
Mary,
I can see, I can see, I can see Superman. Right.
Shout out to Mary.
Okay, okay, next song. Eminem, No Love featuring Lil Wayne, The Game, Pray. According to the slide through group, the Eminem sweeps that whole shit with 4 votes. You understand
what that do?
Yeah,
for sure.
Next one. Eminem, Venom, The Game, Game Bang, Anyway. Eminem sweeps it again with 4 votes to nothing.
Game got one style, he got one way to come.
Next one. Eminem, Beautiful, The Game, Letter to the King.
Letter to the King.
According to the slide through group, Eminem wins with Beautiful, 2 votes to 1.
I think it's Eminem.
Okay, next one. Eminem, Sing for the Moment, The Game, Red Nation.
Sing for the Moment.
Yeah, Sing for the Moment wins.
Hey, I don't care who you are. That shit's dope.
Sing for the Moment wins.
Sing for the Moment.
Sing for the Moment wins. 5-3.
Good job. That was that tight. Crazy. I don't know. That one should have been more respect.
Next one. Eminem. Like a Toy Soldier, The Game. Like Father, Like Son.
Like Father, Like Son.
According to the slide through group, Eminem like
Toy Soldier. Fucking Eminem and the slide.
Hold on. It was close, though.
Hey, good vote. 3-2. Yo, good
vote. It was close. 3-2.
Shout out to our Eminem fans.
That shit is hard.
M fans is riding.
Okay.
Beyonce theory.
Eminem, The Monster featuring Rihanna, and The Game, My Life.
My life.
Well, you know what? You sound kind of right because it was Eminem. It was Eminem 5-1. So you was probably that one, though, Richard.
That's the most domestic violence song in the game, man. You talking about if you don't fuck with me, I'm burning the motherfucking house down, bitch. You know what I'm saying?
Next one.
That's domestic violence.
Next one. Eminem, Rap God. You said this one, right?
I did that one.
Well, this is a different one, though. Yeah, he still won. 7-3. So I must have did that one. Okay. All right. Eminem, Lose Yourself, The Game, This Is How We Do.
Lose Yourself, I do like This Is How We Do.
Oh, I do too. That's one of my favorite songs of the game, but that Lose Yourself.
The game one got like 4 or 5 throws.
Lose Yourself fucking wedges the game. 12-4.
Yeah. That one got a lot of us.
Yeah. Next one.
Does everybody like
the
game?
The Game, Ali. The Game, Kumbaya. Eminem, Forget About Dre.
What was the
Ali Boom Baye by The Game. Eminem Forgot About Dre. According to the slides,
Rich ain't never heard that one.
According to the slides,
that's why he said that.
The Game wins with 6 votes.
Hell yeah.
2.
Hell yeah.
And the last one is The Game's Dream. Against Eminem, I Am, The Way You Say I Am.
Dreams. That's my shit.
The Dreams cleared it up with 71. So we have a total. We have a total. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You know what I'm saying? go into the slide through group. Eminem is the better MC. Make some noise.
Go ahead, Eminem.
You know what I'm saying? Okay. We about to. We almost there. We about to walk through the garden, guys.
Devil out the hole.
You know what I'm saying? The Wire. Season 3. Season 1.
Episode 3.
Episode 3.
Yes, sir.
We seen four.
That's not allowed to talk. I'm not.
Absolutely.
No. Sir. So we're only talking about season 1.
Season 1, episode 3.
I didn't.
We'll brush you. You can just jump in.
Yeah. You know the character.
Yeah, I don't know. That shit eight times.
Let me start off with my notes here, man.
I'm gonna ride with you.
Okay. We learned that Lester Freeman, the guy that makes the little miniature houses, he's not a sucker.
He's not a sucker, but in their eyes, he's the weakest. It came
from pawn shop units for being good police. Then you see these guys. Nobody has a picture.
Wait a minute. How high up was he?
He was a detective.
Wait, God, he was up there.
Air Hustler just went through, came back with the picture, threw it on the table, and went back to making his house.
Didn't even put claims on it. I did that.
Yeah. Just put on a table, went back making his house. Because they was all thinking that they had a whole bunch of fuck-ups. Not knowing that he's good police.
Then he got that pager number.
But he got the pager number off the wall. Another thing that none of the motherfuckers even thought about doing.
Going to the box.
And on top of this, we can just go in. We can go in and just talk about how they're trying to handle the case right now. Because we're from the outside looking in, and we know what's going on,
right?
And we know that by busting, you're not gonna get Avon Marks there like that.
No. It was a small time.
Yeah.
Right.
You're not gonna. Listen, they did their little thing. They got. Only person they got was Bodie. And he's a juvenile, so that ain't even gonna matter.
They walked out.
Walked out.
Listen, at that point in time, they just didn't care.
That's what it is.
They didn't care. They just wanted this to go away. They wanted this to go away. So in the public eye, hey, we did what we could do. We went in there, this is what we got. There ain't nothing else to, you know, open shut case. In their eyes, that's how they feel, and they're sure to win.
But you gotta see, that judge ain't with that shit.
Judge.
You know what I'm saying? He's not with that. So, let's talk about.
He don't have the goat.
Yeah. Let's just talk about,
all these pretzels they got butter on them or something. These are fantastic.
Yeah, butter.
Shout out to Smoked Pretzels.
Butter snack. Hey, butter snack.
Yeah, butter snack. Yeah, I don't know what's going on.
I'm buying pretzels.
Bite it at the same time.
Salt and sweet.
And bite it at the same time. Like, get your little shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Grab a little thing. Like this.
They do this shit in Egypt.
You don't gotta edit that.
That raw right here, dude. Y'all getting that cuisine on the slide through. That's how it's coming.
The church just ain't trying to hear that. The judge ain't trying to hear.
That has everything.
You know what I mean? The judge, they shoot him the bullshit and, you know, tell him what they got, whatnot. He's looking at him like, well, okay, well, where's the good shit, basically?
Yeah.
Do you think that, you know what I'm saying, it was a coincidence that they go
to the spot where old boy shot.
Oh, no, they put it together. That's what I mean.
Like, they said they're going to put him back on the case with his old partner. Mm-hmm. And it was like, whoever put him back on the case knew there was a connection there.
I don't know what happened.
No, they were just searching.
Yeah, his boss came over and told him, I need you to help me find this body. Yeah, he was like, I already got a workload. McNulty's like, I already got a workload.
They didn't expect it to find what they find.
Like they did.
And if you connect it, you see DeAngelo just told it. He told it.
Right.
He told it.
Right.
He told it.
Yeah. He was telling the story to his homies.
And that's the thing, too. Let's talk about him.
He is completely out of pocket.
Like, you know what I'm saying? He goes into the thing, gets paid. He don't know who girl he is. I work with Avon. That's my uncle. Orlando? She's trying to. She don't even know who he is.
Yeah.
No. He just a front guy.
Yeah.
Like, nigga.
That's my uncle.
Yeah, he's like. If you want to talk about clout chasing, it's like, dude.
Listen.
Yo, you didn't have to tell them young niggas about that body. You know what I'm saying? Like.
Look, she was being ignorant as hell, just trying to get him the fuck out of her face, basically. Yeah. Like, you're a nobody. Like, I ain't got time for you. I'm here for bigger things. You know what I'm saying? But then as he started spitting game, because it seemed like he needed something. Right.
He had to use those guys as name. And he still does that, even in the pit with the young dudes. I got some Greek to me. It's like,
yo. I got a body. Right.
Yeah.
That's
why I'm down here.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then let's talk about that, though. I'm going to say like this. See, I don't live there, so I don't know. You know what I'm saying? And it's obviously more black people per capita to where we live at.
Right.
But
definitely.
He catches a body on my watch. Dude, you're off the streets. For a second. You're not in the pit. You're not nowhere.
Right, you're hot.
And then especially after you get them writing down shit, when he went to the thing and started writing that, Because you hot. Even he got the shit cracking down there.
Yeah, he does.
It was like, yo, we ain't never made this much money down here in a minute.
Right.
But he's hot. You see when they came up? Hey, D'Angelo, you would've turned the fuck over. Let Bodie go and all that shit.
But you hot, nigga. But do you think their mindset is, at this time, they don't give a fuck what's going on down here. I can put you right back in there.
Exactly.
Jump back on your feet and handle that down there and make us some money.
Because nobody gives a fuck about us, but still.
I feel you. You still got a body. Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're hot.
There's no other word for it, you're hot.
Like, I know we're from the outside looking in, and the main murder police is on your fucking heels right now. You know what I'm saying?
They know you're walking right now.
You know what I'm saying?
They're watching everything you do.
They needed to sit, like... And they're bad. They needed to sit him down on punishment. Yo, what are you writing shit down? You know what, dog? Go ahead, sit down for a minute, because you know what I'm saying.
How do you count money or something?
Somewhere out the way, where your face is not.
Yeah, you're out the way.
You know what I'm saying? Especially
you're going to DC,
right?
You're going out and Susie's friend in D.C.
Especially when they came.
Y'all work at one of the businesses we own down
came,
there.
When they came and searched
them. Lawn service or something.
And you know what I mean? When they came and searched them, and when Stringer pulled up and seeing them searching them, right there was like, man, yeah, you need to get, yeah. Okay, Stringer, you see that he's weak. You see, can see how Stringer said, yeah, this dude ain't come like that. But that, when you seen that, you should have said, man, get him off the whole shit. Not only because he got a body, you know what I'm saying? And he just got
because
you also know that we can also see that so far that don't nobody see Avon. Stringer is his eyes and ears.
They still have no clue.
So Stringer could be on some fuck shit, you like, man, you know what I'm saying? But it, like, it would be like, but that's what I'm saying. He would be off the package.
Oh, absolutely. He would be absolutely off the
package. But dude, my dude, thing is, this is another one. Introducing
Omar comes in.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've been waiting for this character.
Omar was sitting in the cut in the van watching how sloppy these dudes run this organization.
He knew where the trap house was. He knew where the money house was. He knew where that. He knew where all the joints were.
It's my hero.
He's like, they're sloppy.
My hero,
man. That's why that episode.
Bubs is mine.
Yeah, that episode right there.
I like Bubs.
That episode right there was big for me because, like I said, I never followed the show completely.
Yeah, you had to get
I would catch pieces, yeah. You know what I mean? I watch an episode. I go over someone's crib and they got it playing. So I was watching enough to know who characters were, but not enough.
Right.
So I never seen the introduction. Okay. You know, I never seen that.
Right.
That was like, oh, okay. I was always wondering, how the fuck is this motherfucker gay? Yeah, like, what the fuck? And then you see,
he had the scene though.
He had, like, you know.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh.
He had that interaction.
Right. Right from the beginning, it wasn't no secret at all. Like, he like, oh, yeah, this is me.
Look,
yeah. I don't give a fuck.
I'm straight outside with it, right? Look, straight outside on the steps.
Yeah.
Straight outside on the steps.
Locked up. Hold on though, you seen though when they did the move, when dude said his name, he's like, what the fuck? You see how Omar said it? Like, I don't care if they said
everybody
my name.
Knows my name. Everybody knows.
My name is my name.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I want them to know.
They already know it. I get that. I'm worried about y'all.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Like, shit, they know what it's hitting for over here.
They gotta come.
You know what I'm saying? And just for him to come in there, and again, D'Angelo, with Weebase, you down there getting sandwiches. You supposed to be having a little crew down there. You supposed to be having
this shit's going in crew
money. Up.
Old boy showed up at the door with no gun.
Yeah.
You supposed to have them all.
Your spot's making money right now. You gotta make sure your money right.
You're supposed to have them all tooled up.
Right.
You're up there trying to cheat some out of trade play chess. They supposed to be tooled up.
Go send somebody for a sandwich.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, send one of the runners.
Send a runner to go grab the sandwich.
Because you're down here to regulate this shit.
Yeah.
You're supposed to give the money to Bodie or to Wallace to go get the sandwiches.
Yeah, go get them sandwiches.
You're supposed to have your own muscle. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And all that stuff. Mm-hmm. The guy's not fit. He's not fit for a position.
I'm thinking deep down inside, he knows.
I need to watch.
He's starting to realize it himself.
Yeah,
he's been dead it, whether it's been out of fear that he shot these bodies.
I think, you know what? He's born into it. That's all he means. But I mean, that's who.
He's not feeling
one of those guys.
This ain't me. This is wrong. Something's wrong. I'm feeling it's wrong. Even though I've been involved in this, I've been raised in this.
Yeah.
It's just so something ain't right with me.
So Banks, your angle is like he probably didn't have no choice. His mom.
That's all he knew.
He didn't have no choice. His mom been eating off his brother for years.
Mm-hmm. Brother's gonna be doing. But he saw a 2x2.5 either.
And I think, hold on though. What do you think about? You think those pictures of those the bunks, they played the shit out of him. When the bunk showed him pictures of his kids, he thought him, you know what I'm saying? When he got that right and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But we only know that. You think that might have been some shit that might have broke him, like, damn. Because you remember he kept on saying, man, we ain't got to do this. You ain't got to talk to them like that. You know, worried about the bodies. And then, dude, you talk about the same shit that they told you. Like, you think we worried about dirty and you? Worried about the bodies. Yeah. So I'm looking at like his mind state might be completely opposite now that I say it. So tooling up and protecting the thing, like, no, I don't want to give these dudes no guns because they might catch bodies. You see what I'm saying?
D'Angelo is supposed to do it.
I'm over season 3. I mean,
it's season 2.
I mean,
season 1. No, you're there. You're
last time I started saying some shit, y'all like, oh, no, you can't say that.
Nah, what y'all think of, like, when the raids finally happen and they kick the door up and then dude comes in and says, hey, Kima, the news wants to take pictures and everything. And she said,
we ain't got shit.
Going back to what Minority said, like, I'm not even going on this shit. They change the shits every day, and this will never go to who we want to get. This is
the bottom of the prize.
He did, but it's like this. Now let's talk about Baltimore police for a second. They was willing to let that guy sell drugs and kill people. We didn't. If this motherfucker's catching bodies, you shut the fuck up. If we don't know about it, when we sat here, when he did fuck up, right here with Melty.
What
is up in your ass? He said, I'm up here trying to talk about some street nigga.
He created work. He came out.
He did his own boy like this.
He's a good cop, though.
Yes, he's good police. He's
a fucking good cop.
He's good. Even though boy spoke up to him.
I was motivated.
Even though boy spoke up to him. Like, listen. He fucking saw decals.
He's a fucking great cop.
Oh, he's a hell of a police. He's a hell of a police. Detective or whatever the hell you
are. Organizer.
And you don't want him on your case.
No. Or, like I said, Freeman either.
Yeah.
Officers,
yeah, he's a bad boy.
He's a beast.
Yeah.
He's a beast.
Kima. She was talking that shit before.
Kima's a beast.
Listen.
Only two fuck-ups is Carb and Herc, the two motherfuckers, when they went down to the projects and got their head busted.
He's the one that came back with the picture of Avon.
Yeah.
Yeah. In the boxing, that's when he was in the boxing ring. He was in the boxing he was Golden Glove.
Right to the gym.
And he knows that there was only a couple gyms that he knew.
And he threw it on the
and
table.
He knew people.
And then he heard them talking.
He went straight there and then they got a picture of him. That's the first time they had a picture of who Avon was.
And then McNulty had to go ahead and buy him some drinks. Like, hey, man, let's go ahead and holler.
Because the first picture they found, it was some old white dude.
He's kind of like Minolta, because he a legit cop.
Yeah.
He's trying to break the case.
Yeah, he wants to do good.
So they're trying to throw him away, like,
When they fucked up.
You know what I mean? You work too hard. We got to send you over here.
You're doing too much. You're making us have to do work.
Yeah, but see how they fucked up is, and that's what's funny, they wanted to give McNulty's detail all the shit people that ain't going to solve the case.
They gave him the fail.
They thought they was giving him, because he worked in pawn shop unit, like he wasn't good police.
We're giving him tools to fail.
They brought him back to life. I got a chance to do some good police work.
We're going to put some work in.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, it's real. He was like, oh, it's real. Okay.
Yeah.
They bring him under false pretense. But here they done. They cracking this shit open for real. They bringing it down.
My thing is, bus thing, guys, that is not going to get you Avon Barksdale. That is not even going to get you WeBag. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? That's not.
That man on alert.
That's all the thing they did.
They put him on alert.
You know what I'm saying? Remember when they was hooping? I think they got a snitch down there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that, you see, they, and you see how much bodies are worth.
What about that lieutenant? Do you think he's being set up?
That's what Daniels? I was getting there.
Daniels?
Because remember the Fed pulled up and told McNulty, I didn't want to say nothing because your girl was around, but your boy is dirty.
Right.
And you said, like, they're setting him up to be
a fall guy. They're setting him up to be a fall guy.
Absolutely.
They're saying, because Daniels comes across as good police.
Yeah,
he's stiff.
Stiff. But he's snitching on his guy.
He's kind of like a crook by the book.
Yeah, he's taking it out for his guys.
Yeah.
He's good to his people.
He's that guy that stands behind the shield.
Yeah.
I,
he said,
he was in the wrong.
Yeah.
He said my uppers told me they wanted to see a shit show. I gotta give them a shit show.
Yeah.
Even they told McNulty, fuck it. You don't wanna go to the
way? I know he's gonna mess everything up. But they wanna see a shit show, I gotta give them a shit show.
Yeah.
They that wanna go the... now, I have to go now, basically.
And he said, and they, even his girl, because you know Kima's his girl, she's like, we ain't.
I know we ain't gonna get nothing out. I know we're gonna ruin our investment. We just really starting.
Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna tell you who was really hard body. Your boy, I'm just calling him, I. When he said, we gonna give you 5 years, it's your turn. He said,
Once it goes to trial, he's not gonna do 4 or 5 years.
No.
You know what I'm saying? He's not gonna do the 4 or 5. No. They tried to scare him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And the tactic went right out the door.
I thought he was gonna sing too. Justin even said, Avon Marcel. Everybody know who he is in the tower.
Yeah, I ain't dying.
And then when she said, yeah, give me some names, and he said,
I'll do it. Five years.
Give me 5 years.
Hey, I'll see you.
Hey, because I'm right here. Is out there? Because you gotta understand, they just killed a witness to end, and they beat the case. Right. So their
they're
name
sending
is,
out the message.
Their name is ringing out.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, message already.
You know, he beat the case and they still killed the goddamn witness. I'm not telling. Alright, give me the 5 years.
Yeah, it was the dude that pointed the finger, wasn't it? He's like, yeah, there he is.
Yeah.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
I'm worth 5 years in jail.
Be dead in 3 or 4 days.
But if you understand how they be working, they all be working on their rep. So it's like, he gonna come out as like a soldier. When he come out, he did 5 years as good tall. You know, he might get hit off with something.
He definitely, like Cuddy ended up doing when he got out.
Like Cuddy from the cut.
Yeah. They had a thing up online where they was
keeping track of Game's lies. I say, oh damn. They said, you said it too.
Yeah.
They said he's the biggest liar in hip hop.
I
was feeling him. He was talking about. He said the cat that killed Osama bin Laden
was banging his music.
Was banging his shit, warm blood, right before he killed it. They said that was a fucking lie. They said he might have been listening to it his iPod before they took off or something. But he made it seem like that motherfucker
in the heat of the moment
had one blood playing and was like, that's how he made it seem.
You see the picture and he taped himself to the top? Yeah, he made himself into a picture. He made himself with a picture with Tupac.
Oh, where he wore like Tupac outfit?
No, it was him in Tupac Photoshop and
Photoshop.
Like dude on Coming to America when he put himself with Martin Luther King. Yeah. I mean, I can't find it, but I'm gonna fall back. I can't find the thing. I'm gonna fall back and agree with Chris Clay. Cause somebody, I can't find the thing. They said that the game has mentioned Dre's name. I think it was like 201 times.
Out of all his jams,
You know what I mean? He's opened up songs like Yo Dre, and he's not even on the label. You know what I'm saying?
Yo,
this is the devil's advocate, dog. Yeah. You're not even on Aftermath. I didn't think you want to.
He got NWA tattooed on his chest.
Yeah. So, Game, I think Game can rap with. Yeah. It's just that the gimmicks, he needs to stop. And again, when you don't have that machine behind you and the budgets ain't coming in, I guess this is what people feel
is easy to do.
Wait, you're saying this is attention?
Play with Jay early. Jay got him blackballed a little bit.
Let's talk about that real quick. I'm starting to have another difference about blackball. I'm thinking it's about money. Because I look at it this way. If 50 Cent at the highest of his peak, and I'm a radio station, I'm like, I'm picking sides. It's like I'm going with who's popular. So no job. I don't want you here. 50 Cent's more. Maybe it might be more popularity than Black.
I think it's there's steps to go up.
Right.
And I think Game's going up steps. And who's at the step right here? Jay looked down and was like, hey yo, don't.
Yeah, I definitely.
You know what I'm saying?
Because if you're independent, how can you be blackballed? Yeah, especially with straight humor. Okay, so I'm looking at it as like, if I'm Nike, right? I'm gonna pick sides with Jay because he can make me more money than the game. Not necessarily that I'm not fucking with Game. It's just that he just makes me more money. You see what I'm saying? I want to fuck with 50 because he's hot right now and he makes me more money than what the game could do or any other artist, like whether it be Puff Daddy, like, you know, he brings, like, because, you know, Puff brings sponsorships and all this type of shit. So it's like, I'd rather get along with Puffy than you. Not necessarily that Puffy's making phone calls and saying, hey man, don't play this, you know, don't play this.
Your network increases your net worth. You understand? In that game, you gotta know certain cats. You gotta be good with certain cats. You know what I mean? Like Randy Acker and Lior and dudes like that. You hear them talk about dudes like Randy Acker. Google that motherfucker, who he is. And Lior. Them are the gatekeepers. Puffy and them is tight with them dudes. You know what I mean? Like that.
I feel you.
Your network, man. Your network takes you far, man.
But
takes you farther than your talent.
Your network is a bad
bad song.
It is. That's it why. Is. That's why Dame didn't go nowhere. Thing, Jay did.
This is the thing. With Game, you gotta think about it like this. He had a chance, like we talked about it before, like, is he a star? Yeah, he's a star. He's not a mega star. But you can't, you know what I mean? He's a well-known name.
I would think he was well-known right now. I wouldn't call him a star at this point.
Man, look.
I wouldn't call him a star.
Well, look. Now he went out window. Hold on.
Jay.
That's just still my point. It wasn't even Jay, though.
It was.
Nah, because look, he had this movement, but you got to think, for as much as 50 trolls people and shit trolling, Game, he's out here fist fighting cats all the time. You know what I mean? He got fucking charges over here, charges over there. What I'm saying is, he took himself out of that lane to go to the top. Meaning,
you think he was doing that just to get views?
No. I'm not saying he was. I'm not saying he was doing it to get views. I'm saying he was doing it because he is who he is.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And people shied away from him. You can't bring him to the Super Bowl. He's not friendly.
He's not mortal.
Yeah, he's not friendly like that.
Go back to business. He's not,
you know what I mean? Not that he's not a good rapper, but he's not friendly like that.
He's also unpredictable.
That's that's what that goes to what I'm saying. Like,
so you're thinking as far as business-wise, he's more of a liability.
Yeah,
I'm telling you,
he screwed himself.
If you look back, look at Mixtape Game and Album Game. He's going at Jay. He's going at Jay. But when he was getting really hot, he made hit or love it with 50. Listen to the words of that song. He says there's a line in there. He says something about defining your body and Marcy. That line right there was the final sting with Jay, and Jay was like,
"Well, let me ask you a question.
Don't let that nigga in." If you look at Game's career, he made that hate it or love it. He was here going up, and it never went no more because of that line. Right, go back, listen to that song, "Hate It or Love It" with him and 50 Cent. He says something to the point
how
of,
come, but,
"I leave your body in Marcy."
The advocate. How come Jay couldn't do that with Cameron? Nas, they all came at him, and he couldn't. I'm saying they all came at him, and they're fine as far as making music, and they still have careers.
Yeah, Cam, look how much side shit Cam was doing. Cam, remember, Cam dipped out for a minute, went to Ohio.
Okay, let's just talk about it. Yeah,
got his own money up. Got it with an old camp of dudes. Got his own money up.
My thing is,
up.
If you have the power to do that, you can. We still held Cameron on radio when he decided to come.
Yeah, I don't think he wanted to necessarily murder Cam like Game.
So you think he took it personal with Game?
Like, bro, if you go back and look at Mixtape Game. After Hate It or Love It, he literally has songs where he's a guys in the jail. Like, I didn't mean to.
I heard that.
I think
Smoke is saying, though, it's like you're saying, Jay-Z put the brakes on Game.
Yeah, Nas is still up in his arch enemy. Nas has put out the Nas albums in his
Nas
life.
Nas is bigger than Nas.
I'm telling you right now.
Yeah, but even if you was to say a Cameron.
Yeah, because I would have been somebody like a quote-unquote lower level.
Killer Cam.
They did.
The Future has been talking shit on you.
It wasn't the same.
They did. But they did what Game wasn't able to do. They was able to move out of the lane. and come back in.
So wait a minute.
And Jay was able to move out of lane.
Let me help you out. Let me help your argument.
Get back on my feet.
Let me help your argument.
Come back in the lane.
Let me help your argument. Game was never created that cult culture like an MF Doom, like a Cameron, like a Sean P, where he has this core 350,000 people that's gonna whatever the fuck the game does.
He was a B celebrity, not an A. He was an A list, he's B list.
But the money being under Interscope with Jimmy Iovine and all that, they can kind of make you stars. You see what I'm saying? But once he got up out of the system, the money, they put you in different spaces.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? I think it was too. The money wasn't behind him no more. He had no back. He had no co-signer. 50 was gone. Dre was gone.
Battling everybody. He fought too many people.
And you burned too many bridges. And then you gotta understand, when he came out, you come up under 50 and you're dissing all these people. And it's like, what the hell are you? You know what I'm saying? Who are you to even diss me?
Once that relinquished and you had to stand on your own too, you have to do shit like this.
Yeah.
Talk about you fucked the Khloe Kardashian, a troll. You know what I'm saying? And or talk about somebody or, oh, I'm harder than Eminem and this and that and the other because
Kanye did more for me.
Kanye did more because he shot the game because it worked.
We're talking about you right now.
Wall Street.
Yeah. That's a developer game. It worked, game.
We're talking about him right now. All he's trying to do is create conversation.
Listen,
my thing is, he's
coming like you said. He's selling himself. He's coming back on the scene. He's about to step right back on stage.
I say, well, we're all pretty much like, he had his shot. He didn't capitalize. Now he's at where he's at. And like Smoke just said, this might be his chance.
He's trying to bring it.
He knows it's now or never.
I think Smoke was saying he got a chance now to take himself to that next level because we're talking about him. Is he going to capitalize?
Yes. I never felt as though the game needed to do shit like this. He makes great albums and shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
He does.
The game makes some good ass albums.
He does.
I mean,
yeah,
but
he doesn't have to do that.
Now, he has a big
Let the music speak for itself. You see what I'm saying? But I understand
it. B-list.
I understand that. But you're at least you're in the house. You just might not be in the Jay Z room.
You're at the bottom of it. You might not be at the top.
Club, I learned that with being I'm making this wine. I don't give a fuck. I'm in the room. I feel that. I feel that.
Once you're in the room, it's on you to get into the
That's what I said right now, I'm here to capitalize.
Like, as long as I'm in the building, it's on me to do what I gotta do to get out of the building.
I think game, I don't think he can get harder than he was before.
Right. Listen.
Yeah, he's 40.
I'm not saying that it might be a longevity thing, but as far as right now, he's talking about like he's ready. Like, I think he's learned a lot since his first, you know what I'm saying? This is his project now. It's like, this is his baby right now he's been working on. And even though he's up there in age, man, don't mean he ain't got it.
Yeah, but to be like,
you know what I'm saying? He might not be sitting there trying to be in there for years.
But that's what I'm saying.
He just wanted right now. You know what? I just want to take it right now.
He might be able to do that. But I say like this.
I'm gonna check out his album if it's not out, and we're gonna do it. We'll do a review on it.
I wanna hear it.
I mean, because I don't think the game has to do this, even though. According to the Lathrop group, he got washed in the battle.
know what I'm saying? But I think the game makes good albums. You know what I'm saying? And we gonna wrap this up because it's my birthday tomorrow, bitches.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna probably step out somewhere, but I need songs. Get y'all songs together. What y'all playing now? This is the segment of our show. What is your song? So we let the people see what we're listening to, whether it be old school, new school, rock and roll, country, whatever you're playing.
I know my song already. I'm on some making money thing right now.
What's your song, Banks?
My song is called The Setup.
The Setup by who?
By Obie Trice.
Okay.
I mean,
Obie Trice.
Yeah, bro.
Obie?
Yeah, I'm on some make some money. Gotta get the glass away. You stop for his little lives. I'm trying to school job. I'm trying to pass away. I'm playing. Come on, see these motherfucking rookies in these things. So I can put this. Remember that shit?
Okay,
that's that love without a kiss. That's that love without a kiss. There's a couple guys in that room from that song.
That's that song.
You know what I mean?
Yes,
sir.
We got Chris Clay.
Yes, sir. That was that shit.
What we got going on here, Chris Clay? Oh.
We got her.
Real shit. I need balls,
bro. Yo.
Let me get some back on
you. You want to get some rap, bro.
And you skinny
can't
slap
rap.
That shit up.
You ain't no gangster, you ain't no gangster, you ain't no gangster, period.
You ain't even living like
on that ground, bitch, you get slammed. You ain't no gangster, period.
You some badass, period.
Period, this shit
wrong. These niggas be talking like gang, but I ain't gonna play with you, period.
Okay,
huh? In the back, bullet that boosted you, try to fuck on a period.
Ooh.
I put a bitch up, blood on my hand, it ain't come. You nigga be playing, but I ain't gon' play with you.
Let's go.
I ain't finna play with a nigga. I do what I'm saying. Play on a nigga. These little nigga know I go baby, little nigga. That's baby. That little nigga stay with a bitch. I'm waiting to do it, little nigga. Like the shit that you pop in your music, little nigga. Got a beat that I hit every Tuesday, little nigga. Send a hit. Fuck around and go boost little nigga.
They call me Boosie. I go stupid. Keep it taking serious. If I know you don't know, you ain't gon' play with me, period.
Huh?
I make you walk it out, walk it out, walk it out.
What?
Yeah, I'm talking about. Big mouth shot caller to rock wild. Me no one of my brothers a K. She tryna fuck on the red.
Yeah,
your pussy ass baby daddy be cool, girl. Before I get on his head. Diamonds like yeah, yeah. Diamonds like yeah.
Huh?
I'm a boss. I'm one of your yeah. You gon' die for chasing that clout. I send a buzz in your house.
Yeah.
Same niggas sleep on my couch.
Yeah.
The more niggas get out of line,
yeah.
Them niggas gon' go get a house. I got that music in
my
head. I got them shooters gon' add up. I got the juice. You got the juice. What you wanna do? Bitch, let's hit it off. These niggas be talking like gang, but I ain't gon' play with you, period. Bitch in the back, bullet that boosted you, tryna fuck on a period. I put a bitch up, blood on my hand, it ain't come from a period. You niggas be playing, but I ain't gon' play with you, period.
Let's go. I ain't finna play with a nigga, I do it on sight, ain't gon' lay on a nigga. These little niggas know I go baby, little nigga. That's baby, that little nigga stay with a bitch. I'm waiting, I can't wait to do it, little nigga. Like the shit that you pop in your music, little nigga. Got a pill, I hit every tooth, little nigga. Say, I fuck around and go boost, little nigga.
Oh, I got a bitch from the little one, I fuck like the back.
Yeah, booty is
chick.
I'm up in New York like chicks. My little nigga just flew in a piss. She got out the phone with my people, got shot at the niggas, can't shoot, but they miss.
Every little jam they got, you can do that, man.
I put out hundreds, I blew on my pictures. Nigga be
like,
I gotta do something, I don't gotta do shit but whisper. Like, hey, go bun that nigga, that nigga, and every nigga will.
Nigga know I like to play in my video, play with my kids, and play with y'all bitches.
Uh-huh.
But I bet you I'ma chill up there with God. I play ball on me, y'all, I play with y'all niggas. Bitch,
yeah. Nigga be talking like gang, but I ain't gon' play with you, period.
Yeah.
Bitch, I'm a bad, bullet that boosted you, try to fuck on a period.
Ooh.
I put a bitch up, blood on my hand, it ain't come from a period. You nigga be playing, but I ain't gon' play with you, period.
Let's go. I ain't finna play with a nigga, I do it on sight, ain't gon' lay on a nigga. These little nigga know I go baby, little nigga. That's baby, that little nigga stay with a bitch. I'm waiting, I can't wait to do it, little nigga. Like the shit that you pop in your music, little nigga. Got a beat that I hit every Tuesday, little nigga.
Send a hit,
fuck around and go boost, little nigga.
Bitch ass, nigga. Hey, Boosie, man, give me back that goddamn $15,000 I gave you for that feature. So I'm gonna put it on this nigga head real quick.
Nah, nigga, you getting a whole lot of money now. I tell you what, you just give me 5 G's, and my department gonna have it. And we gonna call it easy. What you think about that?
Yo, a lot of these people out there.
You know, I don't give a fuck what you say about me.
Hell, man.
I want the world to know that if you got, you a friend of mine. You a man. You heard him. I went to the doctor. I got some good.
Yeah.
Go 4 more days, I'm back straight.
Yeah,
straight. So they got everybody on those chairs. Who we got him on? Man, hey, they might put a fake ass on that bitch, man.
You know my ass. How this bitch look when you say something?
My song is King Lemuel, Power Source. Some drill.
Train your muscles until they're under fatigue. If you don't train your mind, then your spirit gets weak. The Ruach Kadesh abides with the humble and meek. Yeshua's coming to bring the full heat, his peak, his peak. Then black lives won't matter. Black, white, Indian, Chinese man gets splatter. I know you though, Please don't let me say I told you so. There's a revolution on its way, and it's not by the color of your skin, but by your alignment within. We may be more receptive through our melanin, but we have to surrender and let the awakening begin. Through him, the one who died for our sin. Galactic synergy, save your seed and transmute natural energy. It's all creativity, so learn what you're telling me. Yeah, G, emotion just moving energy. A precept within a law, Yeshua revealed unto me what Enoch saw, what Daniel saw, what John saw. Adonai fill me up, I need more, I need more. Your character is built by the decisions you make, the promises you break, and when it's all weighed in the balance, it's our souls that's at stake. Checkmate, checkmate, you made the right move, too late. It's all about timing, you have to put the time in. Time is so precious, patience is a virtue. One of the worst things to hold is a grudge. Don't let those emotions hurt you. So quick to worship anything but God, including each other, with no mind for our Father in heaven, or respect for the earth our mother. But soon we'll discover we was born to find our way back. Yeah, it's funny how evil works for good, and nothing seems to go the way it should. It would, oh it would, by his perfect will, if only we just learnt to sit there and be still. Make sure you prepare for what you pray for, so when it comes, it doesn't pass you by. What a tragedy that would be. Stand for what you believe in, or do you're prepared to die. I just wanna be who was called me to be.
It was Smoke Dog drying up all the vaginas. Rich, the Kang. The Kang.
The Kip Kang.
Thank you for coming through the slide through. You understand what I'm saying?
Slide through.
You know what I'm
saying?
You know what I'm saying? And again.
Oh, we got a party this Saturday.
Yes, and again, I need you to relax, sir. We're about to get to it. Don't worry, about it. Let me manage you now. Let me be your manager now. Let me be your publicist. We have 06 in the house, and you know what I'm saying? Before you get into what you got going on in the week, can you please tell people how to get in contact with you, all your social networks, anything like that, so they can book an event, anything like that. Tell the people how to get in contact with you, sir.
You can get into contact with me first. You can call me anytime. 724-212-816-330-8004.
Hit me up. If you want to hit me up, call me up. If you want to call to Mike Jones. If you want to call his number, but I'm just trying to say, like, you might get
Unico Vino. You can find me on Facebook, and my webpage is unicovino.com.
Can you tell the people how to spell that, sir?
UNICOVINO, two words. Also, Monty's Restaurant and Lounge is opening very soon. 775 Freeport Road, Chestwood, PA. Again, 775 Freeport Road, Chestwood, PA. We're having a party this Saturday. We got some hip hop coming in from Detroit, Philly. We got some new Ken artists performing. We got Roku TV coming in to film the whole thing. Everybody's gonna be on film. It's gonna be on this hip hop show that's on Roku. You can check yourself out on there afterwards. Come see us.
And this is when?
This Saturday.
And rumor has it the Smoke will have a residency in there, like kind of like how Frank Sinatra did in Vegas. I'm just gonna show up once a month. You know what I'm saying?
And Nico Vino wine.
And
we got our spots.
Yeah, yeah, and you kind of, you know, maybe say a couple one-liners. Little Rich, the Kang. Can you please tell people how to get in contact with you, sir?
Well, if you want to get in contact with me, man, Facebook, Rich Poe.
Richie Poe.
Rich Aldbury. Instagram, Rich Dollg.
Jerry G?
983.
That spells like Dollgers.
No, Rich Dollar. Dollar. G.
Oh, hey. Z. Apartment. I thought you said G. Hey. Sorry.
Snapchat, Rich Money 1983,
you
know what I'm saying?
Hey, you got all ways to get in touch with
a
little Rich.
All the ladies out there.
All the ladies.
Rich is available.
Yes, I am.
He's on the market. He's on the market.
Like now.
Good guy, man.
On the prowl, too. Hey, gentlemen, check your inbox. Look up, guys. You can get us at, on us on the Slide Through group on Facebook.
Absolutely.
And that's it. We on YouTube. And then all the people that's on YouTube. I'm eating some. I ain't gonna say that. It's my birthday. We'll holler at y'all next week.
Happy
peace.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Let's get that bell.
Let's get that bell one time.
Go ahead and get that bell over there. Yeah.
Here I am.